Tales. Connect and collect with Game Show Network's Interactive Block. Weeknights from 10 to 11:30.
Leave me alone, it.
It's okay.
From Television City in Hollywood, it's Tattletales! Welcome to the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales! And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Conley!
Hello, everybody. Thank you. Welcome to Tattletales. Nice to be with you. Nice to be with you here in the audience, too. As you can see, our studio audience is divided into three sections, the red, the yellow, and the blue, each rooting for one of our celebrity couples. And, of course, every time one of our celebrities wins money, you here in the studio get it. So let's go, shall we? Here are the people going to win the money for you today. For the blue section, Mr. Steve Lawrence and his wife, Edie Gourmet. Steve and Edie. Winning money for the yellow section, Mr. Dick Martin and his wife, Dolly Yay! Martin. Yay! And winning money for the red section, Mr. John Clark and his wife, Lynn Redgrave. Yay! Here we go. Ladies, I can see you all. Can you hear me clearly?
Sure.
Yes.
All right, you look really cute. Here we go. First question is for you. It's directed to the ladies, gentlemen. You must remember that. It's worth $150 to your rooting sections. Ladies, at a Washington, D.C. party, you're introduced to two women. One is a congresswoman. The other is a famous Washington call girl. Which one would you be more interested in talking to? The congresswoman or the call girl? Off you go, ladies. Good question. That's the way to begin a game, isn't it? Steve, which lady would she be more interested in talking to?
Well, there are some political representatives that represent both groups.
That's true, yes.
I tell you, Edie and I lived in Washington for 2 years while I was in service. I was stationed down in Virginia. And we did have the occasion to meet a lot of political people. And it's very stimulating. I think that over the years, because of the nature of the business that we're in, I think that Edie would much rather meet a congresswoman. She's very outspoken, as a matter of fact.
Yes.
Edie is.
Has she, to your knowledge, ever spoken to a call girl?
She's called congresswomen.
But never called a... Yes, I...
She'd have no reason to call a coral girl.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, she might send him a get-well card,
yeah.
You know. You know, just, you'll be all right, just stay out of bed for 2 weeks or something. I think she would want to talk to the congresswoman because she's a political activist in
yes.
a sense.
Yes. Okay, here she comes. Edie.
Yes.
Who would you rather talk to?
Who I would rather talk
yes,
to?
Yes, the question is for you.
Well, there's no question that it would be very interesting talking to a call girl, especially in what. That was not it. That was not my answer.
Okay.
It would be more interesting talking to a call girl, although what could possibly be new? Only the faces change. Whereas, it might be more interesting talking to a congresswoman, since there are not too many congresswomen around.
Mm-hmm.
And
so far, the blue section's going crazy, because they don't know which way you're going to go.
I personally would talk to the congresswoman.
You're right. That's what Steve said.
Yeah.
Very well done. Guess they didn't need your advice, huh, Dick?
I guess not.
No, they did fine.
They stayed together.
What do you think Dolly will say?
Well, I think I'm going to go along with Steve. I think she would talk to a congresswoman because she is, she really wants to become better informed. And, you know, it's hard to, if she's talking to a call girl, she'll fall asleep because she doesn't like to lie down in the middle of the day. So she would, She would definitely talk to a congresswoman.
Yeah. You feel reasonably certain of that, don't you?
Oh, well, I not really.
Here she comes. Yeah. Dolly, which one would you like to talk to?
The Koga.
No, that's not the big thing.
Why not?
That long, reasoning answer, and she's, boy, she snaps it back quick.
I thought you'd gotten over all that, so to speak.
No, I'll tell you why.
You swore you weren't going to talk to your old friends again.
What?
Now, ignore that if
you're
you can,
get...
Dolly, and give us your reasoning here.
Well, my reasoning is that the call girl that makes it, you know, in Congress is someone I'd like to get to know, because there's many call girls, but someone that makes it into the, I'd like to know the inside scoop on who does what to whom.
Doesn't matter how she gets it.
Wait a minute. I'm not quite sure that's what we had in mind when we asked the question, but... A famous call girl congresswoman is what you thought we were talking about.
No, but I mean, this girl's in Congress, isn't she?
No. She's in Washington, D.C., though. You're close.
That's what I meant. Same party, right?
Same city, yes.
Now, there's nothing says she has to understand the question.
No, that's true. We're not grading on the answer. It's not a snap quiz, you know what I mean. I'm sorry, Dolly, but I'll try to be clearer next time, John. Oh. Who would Lynn rather talk to?
Oh, that's funny.
Well...
I think Lynn would rather talk to Dolly after this.
Lynn is the sister who couldn't be less interested in politics. I don't know why, but she is so uninterested in politics. She falls asleep like she did at the wheel of our car the other night. And I'll tell you about that later.
Tell us now. We'd rather... No, that's all right.
And as for American, English politics she has trouble with. American politics she doesn't understand at all.
Right.
But she did play a hooker once in The Happy Hooker.
She sure did. Right.
And she found out how to do that by talking to a lot of not congresswomen, believe me.
Yes.
So I have to say she would rather talk to the hooker.
The hooker?
Yeah. The call girl.
The call girl's
in Washington, aren't they?
Well,
hookers everywhere else. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I think what we're talking about is an economic difference, I think. Here comes Lynn now. Lynn, which one would you rather talk to, the congresswoman or the call girl?
You know, I can't tell you how weird it is sitting back here. We've got this terrible music going in our ears, and the other two ladies who can hear what my spouse has just said are laughing and nodding and carrying on. Anyway, I've talked to a lot of call girls when I researched a character that I played called Xaviera Hollander, but I haven't talked to a lot of congresswomen. And I think I'd say I'd talk to the congresswoman.
That's not what he said. I'm sorry. Steve and Edie get the whole thing for the blue section. Well, that's a good beginning, isn't it? For the blue section, anyway. We'll come back in just a moment after this message. Question number two coming up, guys.
Geico's always been about savings, but he really brought customer service to a whole new level.
We settle a ton of claims in under 48 hours.
Guaranteed claim repairs? That was his idea.
Customer satisfaction is at an all-time high.
You know what he represents? A commitment to excellence.
And he deserves this award.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Dave Logan is single. He goes on many dates.
What is it that you do?
I'm a lawyer.
I hate lawyers.
And he uses his Discover card.
Check, please.
So far, he's built up a cashback bonus award of over $160.
Check, you're kind of boring.
Check, please.
What do you think this thing's going between us? Because you know my clock's kind of ticking.
Check, please.
It's money he'll use for an engagement ring someday.
So what do you do for a living?
Maybe someday soon.
I'm a lawyer.
Discover card's new cashback bonus program.
Really?
Where you get paid for the things you buy anyway.
Frequent persistent heartburn 2 or more days a week despite treatment and diet change may be acid reflux disease.
You never know when to expect it.
The burn can stop you in your tracks.
You worry about the risk of long-term problems.
I got help. Learn to handle the disease and the risks in ways that make sense for me.
Call this number now for information and a free kit from Prevacid, a handbook on managing acid reflux disease and its risks, a risk alert profiler, a guide to making the most of your next doctor visit, and a 7-day free trial certificate to use if your doctor decides Prevacid is right for you. Prevacid fights acid reflux disease three ways. It beats the burn, helps heal the damage, and best of all, staying on Prevacid if prescribed can stop the damage from coming back. Prevacid has a low occurrence of side effects such as diarrhea, abdominal pain, and nausea. So if you want the power to manage the risks, heal the damage, and stay healed, call now for your free kit.
Thank you. We are back. We were just having a little educational lesson from Steve Lawrence on the... And we're back with question number two, and once again, it is for the ladies. And Dolly, you and Lynn have to play catch-up with Steve and Edie. Oh. They got $150 right off the bat here.
No.
This one is worth $150 as well. Here you go. Ladies, you've hired the 14-year-old daughter of some close friends to babysit for you while you're on vacation. You come home a little early and find her smoking pot. Would you tell her parents, yes or no? Okay, think that one over. Okay, that's kind of an interesting, serious question. Dick, what would you... First of all, has that ever happened to you?
We don't have any children, so a babysitter would be superfluous.
Yeah.
Well, probably, you might...
How old was she?
Probably wouldn't need her. you could always start, you know.
Well, I'd say that Dolly would be very angry if it was her pot the kid was smoking. That stuff's expensive today.
Then the front row of bananas doesn't go, yeah, man, yeah. You betcha.
Oh, good.
She definitely would not turn the kid. She wouldn't bust the kid, no.
She would not?
No.
She would not tell the friends?
Never.
Okay,
no,
here
no.
She comes. Dolly, would you tell this girl's parents, yes or no?
I'm not a snitch, no.
That's what he said, you're right.
But can I just say this? I would never hire
her. Snitch.
I would never hire her again. And I'd give her a good talking to.
Yes. Right. I like the way you said that, though. I'm not a snitch.
Not a snitch.
Not a snitch. Thank you, Dolly, so much. What will Lynn say?
Well, we have three kids, and one particularly... A new one, so we are into babysitters again.
Yes, you are.
And I think what would happen is that Lynn would talk a lot to this girl and try and find out why she's doing it and whether her parents know and so on. She definitely would not tell the child's parents, but I think she would try and talk her out of it or convert her.
Talk to the girl, but definitely...
The girl.
Yeah, the parents are friends. I don't want to color your answer at all, but they are friends. They're not strangers to you.
Right. Yeah, no, okay. But still not.
She still would not. Here comes Lynn. Lynn, how do you feel about that? Would you tell, yes or no?
That's tricky. First of all, I don't think I'd hire a 14-year-old while I was away on vacation, but I'd be pretty shocked, and I would be pretty shocked if they were drinking alcohol, too, and they were looking after my kids, and they were only 14. And I would like to think that somebody else would tell me if my 14-year-old were doing that while babysitting, and yes, I would tell them.
Okay, that's not what John said. But I'll tell
snitch.
You...
What did he
yeah.
say?
Well, married to a snitch.
Explain that to her, John, how you felt about it.
Well, what I said, sweetheart...
Yes, darling.
What I said was I thought you would sit this person down and you would talk a lot and try and convert them and find out why they're doing it and get them to promise they'd never do it again.
No, that's what you'd do. You had to guess what I would do. I was going to go on to qualify it by saying that you would sit them down and talk to them.
He would negotiate.
You wouldn't snitch. And I would snitch because I think I'd want to know if one of mine was...
You know, you've changed a lot since we last did this.
See, that's what I told you. Watch
this,
that's
could this right. be the beginning of the end
no,
of 15
not,
years?
No, not really. No, no trouble
darling,
at all. Unless you
this?
Miss the next one, then the
see
red
this?
Section will end it for you. Okay. What was that? You were holding... I couldn't see
I
you
just
there.
Took off the wedding ring.
Oh, no,
it's the
don't
first
do that.
Step.
No, no, no. Steve, what will Edie say? How does she feel
well,
about this?
Well, I think Edie and I are a little bit from the old school, you know, when it comes to that kind of subject matter. We're very square. We were invited to a pot party, and my wife brought along the Tupperware. You know, this is... But I think that if a 14-year-old babysitter, if we, you know, caught that babysitter smoking a joint and they were friends of ours, I would think that if they were good enough friends that we could discuss it with them. And I think I would tell them, because I think they should know what their children are doing and what they're involved in.
Right.
So I think, yes, I would mention it to my friends. These are
now,
friends.
Now, wait, now remember, I'm asking Edie. Do you think she'll feel the same?
I think she definitely will feel the same.
Okay, let's bring her on. Here she comes. Edie.
Yes?
Would you tell your friends about the 14-year-old babysitter?
This is a dilemma, this question, really, because, first of all, I would not want to be a snitch, nor would I want to be known as a snitch. On the other hand, if the parents were really close friends of mine, I'd have to think, well, is this going to upset these people to the point where they will no longer be friendly with me? On the other hand, I have had problems with babysitters, and you have a small baby or a child to think about, and you would not want somebody that's incapable of taking care of your child in your home. And I feel that somebody, especially a 14-year-old, is not an adult, cannot handle the ramifications of smoking pot.
Is it a yes or a no?
As much as I would hate to snitch, considering that the child is 14, plus that she was babysitting or he was babysitting for my child.
We're a little late, Edie.
And the parents were very close friends of mine. Unfortunately, I would have to say yes, I would say.
That's what the man said. You're absolutely right. Edie, you're right. Dick and Dolly are right. We split the 150 and a half, and it is halftime, gentlemen. Will you kindly step to the rear? We shall bring the ladies out front and come back with a second half of Tattletales out of the...
Imagine the power to stop time.
No way.
You could impress your friends.
Zach, your watch is off the hook.
Yeah, that's funny, Zach. That's real funny.
Get the last laugh.
There's that woman who's always giving me parking tickets.
Oh, perfect.
No.
And save the world.
Well, you heard the man.
Let's go. No way.
Clock Stoppers.
With $25,000, you can afford to get a little crazy. You know, do things you ordinarily wouldn't do. Pay online, and you're automatically entered in the DishNetwork.com sweepstakes. If you win, you'll love finding things to do with $25,000, and you'll love how easy it is to pay your Dish Network bill online.
Will you marry me?
You don't have to go that far. Pay online this month, heck, every month, and you could be living the good life with the DishNetwork.com sweepstakes.
Now you can try an incredible pain-fighting formula for free. MagnaBlue can be your way back to an active life. Just imagine being able to do things around the house without having to ask for help. Now there's a way. Try MagnaBlue for free right now. Why pay $39.95 for a bottle of Super Blue stuff when you can try your first jar of MagnaBlue for free? Both have similar pain-relieving ingredients, but you can try MagnaBlue for free. Don't settle for pain when you don't have to. Just call right now and let MagnaBlue help improve your quality of life. We're so sure you'll love our product that we'll send you your first jar for free. That's a one-month supply of MagnaBlue absolutely free. And if you call right now, you'll also receive 5 free travel packs. Each month, we'll send you a new supply of MagnaBlue for just $19.95. Call and cancel anytime. There's no obligation to continue. This offer is not available in stores, so what are you waiting for? Remember, the first jar is completely free.
For jaywalking in Jerusalem.
It's good for girls on a budget.
False pregnancy.
Fairy dust.
Tramps.
Idiots.
Cops.
Get in on the joke with Classic Hollywood Squares every night at 7 p.m. Eastern.
Silly savages.
Hello, we are back. We have changed places, as you can no doubt tell, because I have a much lovelier-looking panel out here. Oh, sorry, yeah. Guys. You look cute, too, though. This question, once again, is worth $150, and it's for the fellas. You got to play catch-up to Steve and Edie. They got most of the money. Men, in the middle of making love, which of you is more likely to start laughing, you or your wife? Goodbye, guys.
What a question.
I love to see their faces. You can't see them, but I see them.
No, can you see their faces?
It's absolutely perfect. Yes, they're gone now, however. Lynn,
does that ever happen
between you and John? I mean,
we laugh a lot, actually. I've always thought that it was one of God's greatest jokes that he invented, that was the way that we all did it. I think it's wonderful. I think it's so funny. You know, you see it on a movie, you know, I mean, you laugh. It's funny, you know. Sometimes I think of seeing myself, I think how funny I must look. Or he must look even funnier. But anyway, I also cry a lot. I'm a great crier. Oh, my goodness, but I do laugh. Now, who would laugh first?
Yes.
Oh, my goodness.
Which of you is more likely to
more
start laughing?
More likely to
so
laugh
that, well,
first.
Well, it is starting
I think
first.
Possibly, oh, dear, I'm bound to get this wrong. It's, I don't... let's say that he would.
He would be most likely to start.
Laughing first.
Yeah, first.
I hope he says that. I hope he does.
Well, wait a minute. You know, it doesn't say start laughing first, but it really implies that. Which one of you is most likely to start laughing? So that means
first.
Yeah,
I'll say him.
Okay, here he comes.
Oh, dear. Please.
Which one of you, John? Which will it be?
Well, it depends which TV show we're watching, I think. however, you do say that one of us is going to do it. So assuming one of us is going to do it... oh, boy. Okay, I'll say that I'm Molly.
That's the one. You've redeemed yourself, sir. The Red Section is back in business. Thank you, John. You're the front runners, Edie, but they're closing in on you now.
I know.
Which one? And you two are, you're both so funny. Humorous, and sense of humor plays a big part in both your lives.
Absolutely. So much so that I never knew how I was going to tell my children about the birds and the bees, because it has always been such a funny thing to me. I mean, I can't tell you. I think it's very exciting, but I think that sex is also terribly amusing.
Yeah.
Also, Steve is so funny anyway.
Yes.
And I have to tell you, we laugh a lot more than anything else. Which I think is why we've been married 24 years.
Yes, probably.
A lot of laughing going on. I'll say, only since it's 50-50, I'm going to take a chance and say it's me.
Okay.
I laugh at him.
You're most likely. I love it when you laugh. Here he comes.
Because I laugh.
Steve,
yes.
Which of you is more likely to start laughing?
I think that between the two of us, I think Edie is the most serious of the two. I have always thought that the naked body, I've always found it very amusing.
Yeah.
So, I mean, aside from being lovely to look at, there are certain things that just make me laugh, and the naked body is one of them. I think that I probably would wind up laughing or amused by it before Edie.
Oh. You're wrong.
That's not what you said.
Ah.
Did you get that early buzz in there?
I think, well, I mean, Edie always laughs at everything I do.
Yeah.
Which is one of the reasons we only have two children.
I'm sorry, Steve. I think we felt that we had the correct answer from you in the beginning there, and
what
we were right.
What was the answer?
The answer was that Edie does first, and he said that...
I think what he said was...
What
that
did he say?
He would laugh first.
I would laugh first.
That you would laugh first.
Yes.
And Edie said she would laugh first. You're still...
Well, he who laughs last.
Sometimes laughs all... Here we go. Dolly. Anyway, you're wrong. Dolly, what's the answer?
Well, this is going to be, I think, easy, because we don't know how old Tricky's going to answer this, but he finds no humor at all in sex.
What does he find, yes?
I gotta tell you, I have found this out to my embarrassment, because I've laughed and he has totally been turned off.
Oh.
And he said, it's not funny, Dolly. So, I'm gonna definitely say it's me.
Okay, you're the one. Here he comes.
Funny.
Dick, this is very important, this question right here for you. What do you think?
I would say definitely Dolly would start.
That's the one. You're right. Dick and Dolly are right. Lynn and John are right. They split it in half. And we'll come back in just a moment and split a last one for you. And it's worth $300. Don't go away.
On Friend or Foe, Kathy voted friend and got nothing. Rachel voted foe and got Kathy's $6,000. On September 30th, it's 5 all-new episodes and a look behind the crust box. Tonight from 9 to midnight Eastern only on Game Show Network.
Ha, 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 ha! The double whammy! Rude, man, rude!
Whammy, the all-new Press Your Luck, every night at 7:30 p.m. Eastern only on Game Show Network.
Hi. Sorry I'm late.
Hey, here we go.
What's the book?
I don't know. Kind of same old, same old.
Mm. Have you read anything interesting lately?
Yeah, actually, I have.
What is it?
Well, you've read the Bible, right?
Yeah.
Well, this is the Book of Mormon.
It's a companion to the Bible. It's another testament of Jesus Christ.
You can now have your own free copy of the Book of Mormon just by calling this number.
I was looking for something moving and uplifting, and this is it. Tell me more. I just feel so peaceful when I'm reading it, and I'm kinder to others, and I have more confidence. It's completely transformed my life.
To receive your own free copy of the Book of Mormon, just call this number. It's a gift from the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
And let me know how you like it.
Okay.
I think you will.
Are you in on it? Go to CheapTickets.com for tons of unpublished airfares you won't find anywhere else. Or call now for our lowest prices on airfares, hotels, rental cars, and last-minute trips. Want to save even more? Check out our last-minute trip specials now and save up to 60%. Cheap Tickets, the best-kept secret in travel.
We are back, and we got to go quick. This one's worth $300, and we're real short on time, guys. Here it comes. It's for you. Did you give any Christmas presents to anyone that you do not like? Yes or no? Off you go. Good question. Your basic integrity question, I guess, but not really. What do you think John will say, Lynn?
No, I think he'll say no. I think he didn't, no.
No, the answer is no.
No, the answer is no.
Okay, here he goes.
Only to those he loved.
John, did you give a Christmas present to anyone that you do not like?
Well, I have a lot of sentimental attachment to giving presents, and so I don't want to make a mockery of it, and I have to say, no, I
That's right. That's what the lady said. Okay. At the moment, you're in real good shape. Thank you, John. We come to you, Dolly. We're working our way up because Steve and Edie are in the lead.
In the past, we have, yes, guilt. But we started a whole new thing, Christmas and everything. No, he says bah humbug.
Mm-hmm. Bah humbug. Right. I know, because I didn't get anything from you this year. Okay, he'll say no. Here he comes. Dick, what's the answer? Did you give a present?
Absolutely not.
That's right. That's what the lady said. So now we got... This will decide the game, because they're tied with you at the moment. If you get it, you win the game for the blue section, Edie. No pressure, of course, intended.
No.
The answer is no. You didn't.
No.
That's right. I didn't get one from you either. Okay, here comes Steve and Edie. I mean, Steve. Hello, Steve.
Yes.
Hello. Edie's already here. What is the answer? For the game, by the way, did you give a present to anyone that you did not like this Christmas?
Well, it's not a question of like or not like. There are some people that you don't like as well. I think that, yes.
No, that's not what the lady said. Dick and Dolly and Lynn and John split the money. Split the $300. The time is up, and the banana section wins it. We'll come back in just a moment and dole out some more money. Don't go away. See you in a second.
Yeah, your favorite show on the Game Show Network with the president chick, Nixon.
It's Kennedy, you dumb foe.
Yeah. Well, they got all new episodes with new friends and new foes and the whole friend and deal.
Be a good fella and watch all new episodes of Friend or Foe weeknights at 10:30 on Game Show Network.
What do I want in a Glade plug-in? Well, it'd be fresh. What about a nightlight and an extra outlet? Perfect.
Glade plug-ins, extra outlet nightlight.
Plug it in, plug it in.
Now that's a bright idea.
Last year, the President of the United States encouraged Americans to join a discount prescription plan. For years, many people have been paying $7.95 a month or more for these plans. But now, it's free. With the President's Discount Prescription Plan, you can save immediately on name brand and generic prescriptions. And it's free. Call now.
Now I'm getting my prescriptions at about half of what I used to pay.
We'll give everyone who calls a free discount prescription card so you can save immediately on name brand and generic prescriptions. There's no cost, no obligation. This card is free.
I can save 10, 20, 30, up to 50%.
The President's Discount Prescription Plan is free. Save immediately when you show the card at the pharmacy or call the toll-free number and order direct. There are no limits, no deductibles, and no claim forms. Everyone will be accepted. This plan is perfect for seniors and anyone without prescription insurance.
You can get great savings on all your prescriptions, including Glucophage, Glipizide, and Avandia.
Call now. And don't forget, the discount prescription card is free.
1-800-377-7360.
Connect and collect with Game Show Network's Interactive Block. At 10, the new word game lingo. At 10:30, friend or foe. And at 11, Russian roulette. Log on to GameShowNetwork.com for details. Game Show Network's Interactive Block, weeknights from 10 to 11:30. See if you can spot the real McCoy next on To Tell the Truth. Then Marty and Jay are ready to play on Let's Make a Deal, followed by the $25,000 pyramid.
How much money did
the banana make? Section won it today with $300. We had $1,000. They will divide $1,300. Not bad, gang. Thank you. Thank you all for watching. This Bert Convy saying so long. See you next time. Bye. In addition to cash award.
Meet Barney. Barney likes to run out on his bill at restaurants. And then there's Aaron. Aaron steals Halloween candy from little children. Who's gonna trust them?
Hey, easy. Come on, kitten.
Find out on Friend or Foe, weeknights at 10:30 only on Game Show Network.
Because of the scrub air filter, the Remington air purifier for cleaner, fresher air. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Tattletales. A Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production. The program was edited for broadcast.